When you need advice, come to Ben and Kelly. It's group therapy on 99.7 DJX.
All right, let me toss the phone number out real quick before we get into this. 502-571-9970. Maybe you've had an experience with it or just want to weigh in, help our listener out who has an issue that really she admits she can't take to her husband or she doesn't want to take to her husband because of how awkward it is.
Yeah, so that's why you come to the Ben and Kelly combo. We're going to help you out.
Yeah, she writes, I'm a happily married woman. I've known my husband's best friend since childhood. We're all really close. He practically lives with us. He's always over. Last week, I had a very vivid romantic dream about him.
Oh, boy.
This has never happened before, and I woke up very disoriented and uncomfortable. Not only was I sleeping next to my husband, but historically, I've never been attracted to his best friend. Full transparency, he started this workout program, and he's dropped some weight and put on some muscle, and he looks good. I mean, he looks really good.
Uh-oh.
But he's like my brother.
Yeah.
So now this whole dream thing has gotten me all flustered, and I was awkward in front of him this past weekend, and it's kind of shaken me to my core. Does this mean I'm now attracted to my husband's best friend? Why do I feel like I'm cheating on both of them?
Oh, wow.
Normally, I'd talk this through with my husband, but I don't want to make him uncomfortable or to make him second guess us or me. And do you think this means anything? Help.
Wow. Yeah, no, I understand why she is not going to him, and maybe even going to any girlfriends might make her feel awkward. Laura said, this means you love your husband. You legit feel bad, and you're worried about having attraction to someone else. It just so happens to be his best friend. It was just a dream. Don't overthink it. With that being said, make sure you're also honest with yourself if there have ever been any underlying feelings.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of people are just kind of saying, you know, it's just a dream. Don't freak out.
Jenna rolls in and says, hey, don't worry. It could be worse. I dreamt one time that I got in trouble for not wearing shoes at work and showed up in socks and got in trouble. Started crying to my manager, who was in her 60s, who I ended up sleeping with. And when I told my husband what I'd done, she then slept with my husband so it would be even. I couldn't even look at her for a year.
That was a dream, right?
Yes.
I was just.
It got a little too real.
None of that happened, right? None of it.
So, if you've got any advice or anything you want to pass on to our listener, that's what group therapy is all about, all right? 502-571-9. Kevin, DJX, Ben Davis, Kelly K Show. By the way, the track list for Adele was released. You can see it on our Instagram at 997DJX. And never a more relatable track list to what she was going through than what she has. Yeah, for 30.
I think her divorce wrote her album.
Yeah, for sure. All right, group therapy. She wants to know, she's happily married. She had a very vivid, vivid, naughty dream about her husband's best friend. And now she's all awkward. And she's like, I feel like I'm cheating on both my husband and with him. And I talk about this with my husband, but I don't want to make him feel uncomfortable or make him second guess me or us.
Yeah, she's just thinking, like, does this subconsciously tell me that I've got, like, underlying feelings or something? She's always looked at this guy as, like, her brother. Now, a lot of people on Facebook are...
I'm telling you, I love the freak flags that are flying.
I know, it's so great.
Love it.
So, Brianne said, I had a dream the Chucky doll came alive and tried to kill me and my family once. Never happened, though. Thank God. But on a real note, dreams are dreams.
Yeah.
My husband had dreams about... strippers once. I only know because he talks in his sleep. He didn't get his coffee and breakfast made for him that day, but it was just a dream. Don't sweat it much and let it go.
I will say that I have woken up and my wife has been mad at me because of a dream that she had where, you know, I was either cheating or, you know, something. I was not being faithful or not doing something good. And she's woken up and had like a bit of a, okay.
Yeah, she's mad at you. And you're like, what? It was a dream. I didn't do it.
I know. It's going to take a minute for me to just let this wear off because it was really fresh and vivid. Ryan rolls in and says, I had a dream about being sexual with inanimate objects. Just walking around, making out with mailboxes and wine glasses. She's like, you're attracted to your husband's best friend. So what? You're human.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, Susie says, I think you were just subconsciously noticing him bettering his physique. Try to shake it off. Forget it. Harry said, if dreams really meant anything, I'd be rich living in the Bahamas. I'm not, though. So I would just leave it at that. Just a dream.
Bev is all like, I once dreamed my husband took another woman and her kids to this fancy restaurant we could never afford. Oh. I was mad at him forever, LOL. 25 years later, we've still never eaten there.
Oh, wow.
And then she says, when I mention it, he's like, oh, yeah, I took that other woman there, didn't I? And then he laughs.
Yeah. This is fun. Yeah. I love people sharing all of their weird dreams. Like, this is like kind of a whole little sub-conversation by itself. I love it.
Yeah, so I think everybody is at least, should give you comfort in knowing that, look, a dream's a dream. Doesn't mean you actually did it. Yes, there could be some crazy psychology at play where you can look deep into it and say, well, maybe you are this, that, and the other. But here's the thing. It's like, it's just a dream. You could even bring it up in a joking way to both of them.
You know? Oh, yeah, well, but then do we do that, though?
And
I
then,
feel like that could make
no,
people awkward.
You bring it up in a joking way to both, and then you give a little wink.
I don't think that's what we do. I don't think that's what we do. We just chalk it up as a dream. We move on. It's fine.
And
I don't
think
we talk.
Saying do that because then we need an update.
No,
follow-up,
sir.
All right?
Do not listen to Ben's
advice. No, listen to me right now. And the words that are coming out of my mouth.
No.
And I think the best way to approach this is to just be upfront and go right directly to your husband and to his best friend and just say, you would not believe the dream I had last night or last week.
Do not believe anybody with a mustache like that. Like, that's not what we do.
And then say it. Get their reaction and then wink and walk away.
No, 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 no. That's not what we do. Everybody's like posting GIFs for let it go. Let it go.
All right,
just let it
go. Seriously, it's a dream. Seriously, do that and then keep us updated. All right.
Seriously, let it go. It's a dream.
All right.